When we hear the word tshuva, the first thing that comes to mind is remorse, regret, and not necessarily such a good feeling. We look at opportunities that were lost. We look at things that we could have done better, things that we failed at yet again. And it gives us such a not good feeling, such an uncomfortable feeling. I could have done better. But really, we have to understand what tshuva means. Tshuva does not only mean regret, it also means to return. Where are we going back to? Where are we returning to? We're returning to our soul. We're returning to our essence, to what we really, really are, to our truth. Now, for us to do tshuva, we need to understand who we really are. Who are we? What are we? Are we simple human beings that are doing the best that we can, trying to live, trying not to sink in all the problems and all the challenges of life? Are we trying to hold on to what we can in order to save ourselves and to save our loved ones from not being drowned in the drama of life? Is that who we really are? For that, we really need to go deeper and see that there are two components to our lives. There is the part of us that needs to be saved and that needs to solutionize all the problems and challenges. But then there's a part of us, and that is our real essence, and that is who we really are. And that is a manifestation, an expression of God in this world. When we see ourselves as a manifestation of God, then learning about God's will, which is in the Torah, and doing God's will, which is His will in the Torah, which is the performance of mitzvahs, becomes almost natural to us, because that's who we really are, and that's why we came to this world. So tshuva is going back to that essence, and to returning to our soul, and to returning to our essence. Seeing ourselves not as something separate from the divine, but seeing ourselves as a manifestation of the divine. And how do we do that? We do that when we express God's will and God's wisdom in this world by learning Torah. When we do a favor to someone, when we give charity, we give tzedakah, when we learn Torah, when we smile at someone, and when we look at ourselves as the channel and expression of godliness, then everything else just starts flowing in such a different, real way. And the way that we see ourselves, that is the way the world will look at us. And in that way, we will have more and more opportunities to express godliness in this world. So the next time you do another mitzvah, you're not doing something distant from yourself. You're doing what you came to this world for, and you're really expressing your soul. You're expressing your essence. And in that way, you're going to find true joy, true serenity, and true happiness, and true wholesomeness in your life.
Eu estou muito feliz de convidar todos vocês desse incrível seminário que a IWU Brasil está promovendo, que acontecerá dia 1, 2 e 3 de novembro, num hotel 5 estrelas, lazer completo, comida de primeira, a presença renomada do grande Rav Zamir Cohen, o presidente mundial da IWU.
Essa chance de conhecer a personalidade, o sábio Rav Zamir Cohen. É uma oportunidade única que a gente tem aqui no Brasil, pelo mérito de toda a família IWU.
Vai ser uma oportunidade incrível de você se inspirar, renovar as energias, curtir muito, aprender muito. E eu tenho certeza que essa experiência durará para sempre.
Venham participar desse seminário magnífico.
Espero todos vocês lá.